Hello, and welcome to episode 3 of Thornton Farm Let's Play with Dusty Dave. So, last episode, I cut that field and tethered the grass. And then remembered I hadn't bought a rower. And to be honest, it's not really big enough for square bales. So, start this one up and get him warmed up. And take this one, get that one warmed up, stick the beacons on, and take the header across, and start field number 19. Get that one, harvested as well. I'm thinking about adding the rental mod into my folder. I don't currently have it. So, I was thinking about planting all these fields with maize. Possibly even just renting one so we can do some whole crop. I don't see a whole lot of whole crop videos. I quite enjoy doing that. So we may stick a load of maize or some grain in these fields so we can get some whole crop done. Once we've done that, then we've got a good amount of silage, or we should get a good amount of silage to feed the cows on. There is a BJ on here. That's some fast way of making money. I don't particularly like doing that. But, what needs must. I don't want to take this let's play too fast. Good thinking, wasn't it? Putting that one in front of it. I think there's a different grain in here anyway. I think it's wheat in here. I have a barley in the trailer. Oh my god. Yeah. Brakes aren't the best on this combine. Way. The brakes really are not good on this combine. So, gotta go around that way, make sure the pipe's on the outside. Yep, we've got different grain, so we're gonna have to, we're gonna have to tip off the trailer. Let's see if I can do this with straw wheel. Yes. We'll leave auto combine to it. Should be fine. There's nothing for it to collide to within this field. We'll go tip this up for a little bit more money. Around the corner, try not to drive on the crop. Might do some forestry at some point. This map has got a pretty good forest on it. So, might do that at some point. One thing I do want to check on is the price of that field over there. Close enough to be good for a farm. Just run up the road. 13,000. Yeah, so fields on this map, they're a pretty good price. Big enough so you can make money out of them, not too big, so you skint yourself out trying to buy them. Pretty good. I think my fields on Ventnor Estate, they might be a bit pricey. It's hard trying to get field prices right. You gotta find a good balance of cheap without being able to buy the whole map off of one harvest. I think that's one thing the Giants did get quite right, is the field prices. See, they got that quite good. And that's that. The field. Try not to drive on the other side of the road too much. So many good things on this map. Like the steam train oxygen dude we put in, you've got the jets flying around. He's done some good work on it. This field is rather tiny. We're working underneath the castle. We'll leave that one on. And let's take this one out. Alright. Now pry. Should be. Going to get ourselves a rower. So we row that up. Another mod I've been contemplating getting, especially now I'm doing a Let's Play, is Follow Me. I do see the good usage of that. You know, you take two tractors up, get equipment from the shop, come back, you got it all back in one go. I do see the appeal of that. Don't know how to use it mine, but I can learn. I'd like to get a tractor in there cultivating at some point as well. Stone Henge up there. Don't know what's going on right now. Getting quite a few frame drops. It's a problem with my PC's being on most of the day. It tends to get a little bit slow towards the end of it. I don't know why. Go in there. I could have just gone in the second entrance, but never mind. Right, over to the shop. Got up outside the workshop here. Right, oh, trying to scale the building. Alright. What we got here? We want wind rowers. And class rakes is the big one. Got the rock. That's a bit expensive for what we need. I do like that one. But look a bit big on the tractor. I have to go with this one, I think. A little bit more expensive, but it's appropriate from the shop we're buying it from, as is a class. So, very appropriate. So, take this back, row it up. Might as well just square bale it. I don't want to go wasting money on a round baler right now. I would like it once I can afford it to get the fusion free. Put that one in. Now you can make normal silage out of that then. Be a lot easier. Oh, I think the fusion would go well with a tractor of this size, the 6616. Go very well with it, I reckon. I'm baling some fields up. I would have liked to have gone full rotor rake, but considering this is the only grass field we got right now, I think that's a bit excessive. So, two, it shall be. I see on the glance mod here that the combine is nearly full, so we'll just put the tines down on that. We'll skip across to the combine and to the tractor. Let's try and turn this around without hitting any wheat. Burn the trees there. Let's get this thing empty. This combine does empty really, really fast. Which does help us out quite a bit. It might go out of range here. So I'll just have to catch up with it on the straight. I'll wait for it to line up here. And then I'll catch it on the straight. So here we go. I think a full load out of the combine is about 52% in this trailer. So it takes a good couple of loads to fill it up. Well, we've got a bit more in here this time. That's because I'm following him when he's still combining. Alright, so here we go. Hopefully I'll collect it all. I don't want, really want to go wasting any of it. Such a small field, we're going to need every bit of grass we got here. Ooh. I'm not going to be able to do anything with that. Oh my god. Should have left bigger headlands. Come on. I don't think it's even worth going around twice in this field. Even with a two-rotor rake. And hopefully it will collect it off of... yeah. We'll grab some of that. Start going into this one here. Get the swing around here. There we go. Makes it a bit thinner on the corners, but I'm pretty sure we'll be alright. It's not like we're wasting any grass. This may look like I'm going around for a third time, but I'm not. Just putting it into this row. I know I'm barely catching anything here, but turning on this tractor is not the best. Good job that rises above that wall. Otherwise we'll be off, back off to the shop to buy some new tines for this thing. So, a couple more times hopefully. Try and get full spread on it this time. Go. And it's probably not going to be wide enough. Good job there's nobody in that road. Get the reds taken off like this otherwise. It would have been wide enough if I could drive properly. And just, there's no point in a bale, I can pick that up. Oh my. One downside to using an Xbox controller, you try and do things quick. Like using the left bumper. A, it's meant to fold it up. You don't catch the bumper correctly. You just press A, it detaches. Not the best. And this yard is starting to fill up with equipment. For some reason, I really struggle reversing these things. We'll drive forward. And then back again. Alright. I'm not sure if this Massey has got enough power to pull this crone baler. Not too sure on it. Ooh. We'll just try and power up in the yard. I'm not too sure whether it meets its... So it's letting it power it. Whether it can pull it uphill, that's a different matter. I know the 7626 struggled with this one in that field on the first video I did on this map. I got rid of that tractor because I just had too many tractors. And I'd rather see the Massey go than the than my Fendt 939. Yeah, this isn't gonna cut the gist. This isn't gonna be able to do it. I can actually feel it pulling the tractor sideways. The 939 would be powering up here right now. I'm going like 5 mph or 3. Good job I've got wide tires on it. Plenty of grip laid down. Yeah, absolutely shoot across the top and back down. But it will struggle. Like this. That's if it can turn. The weight in this thing pulling on it. Oh, now we're going to get to see the speed rising. There we go, shoot down the hill. Along the bottom. And then we start to lose our speed again. But at least we're a lot higher up the field this time, by the time we lost our speed. Yeah, this field's pretty pointless. I don't really think it was fully intended to be a good grass field. I think it was just mainly thrown in there for a good reset point. What I should have done is field 15, should have seeded in the grass rather than plant rye in there. So if I had turned it into grass, we would have had another small grass field. Wouldn't have had to buy one. No, that one up there I'm tempted to buy as well. Oh no, it's probably not too bad a price. Ooh. Yeah, the weight of this bale is no good for this tractor. Gonna have to buy a new Massey at this rate, I'll burn this one out. Come on, Massey, you can do it. Oh, inside the baler there. I love the effect off of this one. All the dust coming out. Don't necessarily see it too much on hay like that, but you do see a fair bit of dust on straw. A nice effect, I think, just adds a little extra to the mod. I didn't even want to turn around that time. What I will do here is fold it up, turn it off for the hill, and come back down. I know it's cheating a bit, but needs must. If I wasn't so lazy as to take the mowers off the 939, we would have been fine. I could have stuck the mowers just on this. The mowers work fine on the 6. but... don't know why, I just didn't do that, to be honest. Would have been a lot easier. Maybe if I buy another grass field, I will do that. Just a little bit of grass there. I don't think it's going to make a massive amount of difference. And down for the final part. So... oh, no combine is full. I better go and empty that one. Just chuck them two off. Alright. So, how's that one's emptying? Ooh, stuck on my blades there. Jump into this and I will switch it to that. And we're full up. So I'll just back this one out. Take this one to the shop, bring it back in the field, put the chrome baler away, and I think that'll do it for this episode. So, yeah. I think this kind of length of a Let's Play will do me. Just over 20 minutes. It's not a bad size of video. I could go for ages. I'm thinking of, live streaming some gameplay on Thornton. I mean, it means a lot more work will get done. You will miss things in the Let's Play, because you could watch one episode, come back, next episode I've harvested all fields, they're back seeded again, because I've done it on the live stream. But, you know, let me know what you think of that. If you'd like to see me play live, you can ask me questions for it. And that was some playing live. Should be quite good doing a live stream. I've only ever done one that was on the original Willow Tree Farm. Alright, let's get going. Back up to 32,000. So it hasn't really damaged us having to buy a rake. And to be honest, we needed the rake. I forgot to put beacons on again. I always forget to do that. Alright, put this one in here. Next episode, I think we'll do some baling. I think, of the non-grass variety. Oh, backing over the bale now. Anyway, thanks for watching.